Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. It's Eva from Bohemian Crafting here again, and today we will do those metal charms out of paper. What you will need to use, you can use the embossing folders and emboss some cardstock like this. It's good to use some heavy cardstock, but you don't have to, you can make layers. Once you have embossed your cards, or paper, or maybe cereali boxes, cut them on pieces you would like to make like your embellishment. You can also use paper punches like this or like this, and cut pieces from cardstock and glue them together to some layout like this, and maybe you will leftover like this. So here I have used this butterfly. Then I punched the circle around the leftover from that butterfly, and then I punched 1-inch circle and I laid underneath. So I made here I used leftover, and here it's that butterfly. What you will need next, it's hot glue, of course scissors for that cutting. Once you have your pieces done, you can used also those cereali boxes to glue like a frame underneath. It's good to have a frame around the piece you would like to see, like your embellishment, like around that number five. It's good to have here. I've got number four, so it's kind of similar. It's good to have frame around it, because there you will need jump ring. And I'm gonna take this number four. Take your hot glue. Put a little bit of glue where you would like to have that jump ring. And place that jump ring on that piece. Do not burn yourself. And press it down. And then with that hot glue, you will make very slowly, I hope it will go well, yeah, very slowly lay out over that ring. You know, when I'm taking video, it's never good, but believe me, if you will be in a nice and peaceful time, and if you will go, I'm sorry, I have to lay down, I hope you will see that properly. So go with that hot glue and very slowly. Make a layer around that piece. Be careful, do not touch that hot glue, you can burn yourself. It's good that hot glue, it's drying fast, so you can wait, you know. With one side, you can wait until it will dry. Then you can move on to that other side. So here I'm gonna wait a little bit. I think this is dry already, so I'm gonna... Oh, this is not dry yet. If you will do something like I did now, don't worry about it. It's still hot glue. So you can use your hot glue gun once it's dry and it's hard, go with your hot glue gun around that piece and kind of flat it. Melt it again with your hot glue. Be careful, do not burn yourself. But very carefully you can spread that hot glue where you need that, if you will be not precise. But believe me, if you will do it in nice and peaceful and quiet time, it will go well. It doesn't go well because I'm taking video. It's always same. And then last piece. Do not rush. Just be careful. I'm gonna let it dry. Then, once you have put your hot glue on that piece, you will need to put there some black ink. I'm using this black Sharpie, and I'm going with that Sharpie on that hot glue piece, and I put black ink on all my cutouts. I've got one prepared here. I've got four prepared here. So once you have prepared those pieces, hopefully I can move it. Yes, I can. So I'm gonna let it dry. Those finishing touches. There is many products you can use. Maybe you have markers, those metallic markers. Try to use them. Maybe you have those Prima Marketing wax. And they've got so many beautiful colors. Maybe you have rusty patina. Use any metallic painting, if you have any. And then just go to put your metallic paint on this piece. And I'm using my finger, because with my finger I can manage that much more nicely where I want to have that paint properly. It's kind of a messy technique, but I like that result. With that hot glue frame, it looks more realistic. Don't forget the backside, because it will be hung like a charm in our journals, or maybe, I don't know, maybe on keys. Who knows? Believe me, if you will, don't take a video that putting the layer of that hot glue, it's going really well. If you will, don't rush. If you will, go slowly. A little bit difficult it's to do it with that circle. I'm always placing my finger to the middle, and I'm going really very slowly. I'm holding this hand straight, and with this hand I'm going very slowly, and then again very slowly. I'm not gonna show that on camera, because it's really very slow process, and I know I will mess up on camera this one, but it's possible. Look, it's possible to do it. And always, if you will be not satisfied with your result, you can go and repair it with this one. So this is my sharing for today. Use any punches, any maybe dies, you know, but maybe you wanna make your piece from dies, so use that and put them together maybe in few layers and make it like a metallic piece. So I hope you will enjoy it. I hope you will get to your craft room and you will try it. Thank you so much for visiting my channel today. I hope you will have a wonderful day. Take care about yourself and see you next time. Bye.